जवान, मैदान, आदि पुरुष, सत्यनारायण की प्रेम कथा एंड ब्लडी डैडी, अ ब्लॉकबस्टर मंथ ऑफ जून विद दीज फिल्म्स बीइंग रिलीज्ड इन सिनेमास एज वेल एज द ओटीटी प्लेटफॉर्म. व्हिच वंस विल बी अ हिट, व्हिच वन इज लाइकली टू बी अ मिस, लेट्स फिगर दैट आउट, शैल वी. Hello everyone, this is Kabir Aditya, your lovely host. Welcome back to my new show, Hit or Miss, a show where I discuss and analyze a film's box office performance before it has been released and also after it has been released, by keeping in mind the creative, technicality, financial and marketing and branding factors of the film. So what we're going to be going over to films releasing in June is Shah Rukh Sir's Jawan, Ajay Devgan Sir's Maidan, Prabhas Sir's Adi Purush and Kartik Aaryan's Satyanarayan ki Prem Katha, as well as Shahid Kapoor's Bloody Daddy, which is going straight to the OTT platform. The rest are being released in cinemas. So which ones will be a hit or a miss? Let's begin. Jawan. A film starring Shah Rukh Sir, Nayanthara, Vijay Sethupathi Sir, and possibly cameos by Dalapati Vijay, Sanjay Dutt, as well as Allu Arjun. The cameos haven't been confirmed, but this is the buzz right now. It's directed by Athali, a Tamil film director, as well as music is given by a master in his field, Anirudh. So we all know that songs are going to be a chartbuster. The background music is going to be as amazing as Kabir Singh's, or if not, even better. And after Pathan's humongous success, there's nothing stopping from Shah Rukh Sir's Jawan from being a hit, because already it is going to be an action thriller, as we all know. I don't know what the movie's about, but I can already predict it's going to be a hit. Not because of his fandom, but because he's riding on a very, very successful film. People are eager to watch him again on screen. People know Athali's way he makes blockbuster, larger-than-life experiences, action films on screen. He's been very successful in that. The music is already by, as I said, Anirudh. That's going to be very successful. The actors, Vijay Sethupathi Sir, is not only hugely popular in the south of India, he's also very popular in the north as well now, in the Hindi-speaking parts of India as well. For example, in the TV show Farzi, the web series by Rajan D.K. Sir, he was loved in that show. He was also loved in Vikram Vedha, the Hindi dubbed version of the Tamil film, the original one with Madhavan Sir. And then people already have so much buzz to see Vijay Sethupathi Sir alongside Shah Rukh Sir. And this also creates a bigger audience for the southern parts of India as well to watch the film. The southern director, a southern actor, a southern actress with Shah Rukh Khan, who's loved across the globe, let alone other parts of India. So it's not only relying on fan power, but we know the quality of the filmmakers that are there, the actors. Even a little teaser of it created more buzz than any film I know right now. And after Pathan, people are just eager to see what else Shah Rukh Sir has to offer now. It's surely going to be a hit, and because it's being released in the first week of June, it doesn't have any competition with the big budget films. So will it be able to beat Pathan in terms of box office collections? I'm not sure. I have to watch the trailer and figure that out. But I would say it's going to be a little difficult because there are more big budget films releasing in other weeks of the month of June itself. So maybe that might help, because Pathan was riding on not many big films being released except, say, Shahzada and other smaller films that got eaten away badly by Pathan. Here we have many big budget films coming up. So that is difficult to say whether it will beat Pathan's collection or not, but will it be a hit? 100%. I hope it's being released on time. If it gets postponed here and there, when it will be postponed for. So we'll figure that, we'll see what happens with that. But I don't think the release date should matter as much, because it looks like a big hit. Now let's get to Adi Purush and Maidan. Adi Purush is, Prabhas's film, directed by Om Raut, who has previously made Tanhaji, which was a humongous hit. But the posters, the teasers didn't create positivity among the audience. In fact, it created a more negative buzz attached to the film. It's already a 400 crore plus film. It's been delayed because of VFX effects. It had already been delayed and it's been delayed even further now. It's also doesn't seem appealing to the audience now itself, so I don't think it's going to be a hit. It's probably going to be a miss among the audience. The huge budget works against its favor. The negative buzz works against its favor. And people already feel that it doesn't justify the magnum opus a story like Ramayana deserves on screen. Everyone's saying maybe Rajamouli sir should have directed a film like this. So for me, it's a miss. Also, it's being released alongside Satyanarayan Ki Prem Katha, so we're not sure about that. But we'll see. I'll come back to Satyanarayan Ki Prem Katha later on. Maidan, it's been delayed again for other creative issues and whatever issues they've had. It seems like an expensive film as well, about 200 crores. Not only because of the delay, but actors nowadays charge humongous fees, and you can tell it's a period film. So it already, when it's a period film, the costumes, the production, the design, everything, the sets, they take time to make. It costs money. And when it's been delayed, it costs even bigger amounts of money. And it being really, it does look like a very, very high quality film. However, if Jawan works as well as Pathan, Maidan won't survive. It's doomed to begin with. But even if Jawan doesn't do as good as Pathan did, I still don't anticipate Maidan recovering its humongous budgets in the month of June, because it will have a very, very small window to recover that huge amount of money to even call it an average film. So, and also the big problem against this is that it's about a football coach and his team, and even though it's based on true events, people are already going to compare the story to Chakta India, which is a huge benchmark to beat. So because people already are going to compare to other films that have already successful, the high budget and everything, I don't think it's going to create as much buzz among the audience as I would like to, because it looks like a very, very high quality film. But this is just my take, so it's another miss for me as well. Now coming back to Satyanarayan Ki Prem Katha, it's being released alongside Adipurush for now, starring Karthik Aaryan and Kiara Advani in it, after Bhulbhulaiyaa 2. We go by the past to how what Pathan did to Shahzada. You know, Shahzada had to get postponed and it still didn't work for various other reasons, but also because Pathan was still on its rampage on box office business. If the same thing happens here, Satyanarayan Ki Prem Katha will not survive the storm that is coming in June, regardless of how good the film is. I do not anticipate them releasing it in June for now, because there hasn't even been a poster release or any teaser or anything, and judging by the month of June cramped by films, I'm pretty sure Karthik Aaryan will not take the risk of releasing it again nearby a Shah Rukh Sir's film. I'm pretty sure it's going to get postponed to either mid-July or somewhere around that time, and if the film is obviously well made, then we can say that it might work. But if it's definitely being released in June, it's a miss. Only because of the rampage of the films that are coming up. Even Ajay Sir's Maidan will be enough to beat Satyanarayan Ki Prem Katha. That's just my opinion. We'll have to wait and watch. Bloody Daddy, an action film directed by Ali Abbas Zafar, who has made films like Tiger Zinda Hai, Sultan, Bharat, Mere Brother Ki Dulhan, and I also believe Gunde. So he's made some really, really big films for big distributors, big production houses, big superstars in the film. He's a cinematic release guy. He's larger than life, even though his last film, Jogi, was straight to OTT. But that was a very well-made film. But I'm sure why they didn't release it in cinemas, it wouldn't have worked because of the topic and stuff. But however, he's a great director in my opinion. But why, if he's making an action film, why is it not being released in cinemas? It could have easily been released in May where there's no film around. No big budget movie around. I'm pretty sure the budget of this film is about 200 crores or 150 crores itself, because actors nowadays, like I said, charge a lot. It's an action film as well. The director probably charged quite a bit. The production itself looks like an expensive film. But if the producers are not confident enough to release it in cinemas and they're straight away releasing it to OTT platforms, I'm pretty sure they're not confident in their own product, which means it's probably a miss to begin with. It's already a remake of a French movie. It's an action film. Why would you not release it in cinemas? At least when there's no films around. Even if you're not confident, release it. It's an action film. It should work. Plus, Ali Abbas Zafar already has a great history with big budget films and action films and those cinematic experiences films. Most of them have worked. People are not happy with the final cut, the filmmakers and the creators and the producers and stuff, which is why it's being released to the OTT platform straight away. And I mean, it could be argued that the Russo brothers released Extraction and The Gray Man straight to the OTT platform. They were quite popular among the audiences, but you also have to notice they were under high pressure after delivering movies like Avengers Infinity War and Avengers Endgame. So they probably weren't that confident into releasing these films in cinema either. So if the Russo brothers were not confident enough, which means they knew the product is not going to work in cinemas. But that was because of different reasons, because of the history they had. It could be that's the reason Ali Abu Zafar is releasing it straight to OTT platform. But again, Hollywood movies have more competition with a lot more films being released at a particular time. Here, you have the whole month of May where there's no well-known big-budget film with an A-lister being released. You have a whole month. It's already the film is ready. Start marketing it and releasing it like first or second week of May in cinemas, and there you go. You have it. Maybe, in my opinion, it's a miss to begin with. Although I will watch it and I will make reviews on it and stuff in all these films, but my final verdict is that Bloody Money is a miss among the audience. So this is that's it for today's video, guys. And the blockbuster month of June with these four releases and the fifth one on OTT platform. So this is my verdict. Jawan is going to be a hit. The rest are probably going to be a miss. And Satyanarayan Ki Prem Katha depends on when it's going to be released. And also Bloody Money, a miss. So this is my final verdict, guys. I hope you all enjoyed the video. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. And if you enjoyed the video, do press the like button and also do not forget to subscribe to my channel and smash the bell icon as hard as you can so you can get instantly notified whenever I upload a new video. Until the next episode, cheers, guys. Take care. Bye-bye. And keep watching movies.